Welcome you all. In this chapter, we are discussing conduction and breakdown in liquid dielectric media. So, in the previous concept, we understood how actually the conduction and breakdown is took place and different theories in the case of gases dielectric media. So, liquid dielectrics, because of the inherent property, they'd be more useful as insulating material than the solid and the gases. Because both liquids and solids are usually 10 to the power of 3 times denser than the gas. Hence, from the Paschen's law, it should follow that and possess much higher dielectric strength on the order of 10 to the power of 7 volt per centimeter. Oil is 10 times more efficient than the air and the nitrogen. It has heat transfer capability when used for the transformer oil. This is the reason behind we are choosing the liquid as a dielectric medium in the case of the transformer oil. Although liquids are expected is around 10 megavolt per centimeters, in practical we may get 100 kV per centimeter. So we are using the liquid dielectric media in cables, capacitors, transformers and the circuit breakers. Petroleum oils are the most commonly used as a liquid dielectric medias. So synthetic hydrocarbons and halogenated hydrocarbons are also used for the certain applications. The liquid dielectric normally or mixture of hydrocarbons and are weakly polarized. So when used for the electrical isolation process, they should free from moisture content or product of oxidation and other contamination. If there is a presence of only 0.01% of the water content in the dry transformer oil, the dielectric strength will reduce by 20%. So this utmost care has to be taken in the case of the capacitors, cables, as well as the transformer oils. Then coming to the classification of the liquid dielectrics, I am not going in deep concept to the different classification, just I am explaining what are the compositions of what are the different type of the liquid dielectrics are. Transformer oils, it is almost colorless, consisting of mixture of hydrocarbons, paraffins, isoparaffins, naphthalenes and the aromatic hydrocarbons. So when in service, so it is liquid in transformer is subjected to a prolonged heating at a temperature of 95 degrees Celsius, and consequently it undergoes a gradual aging process. So when the time overs, the oil becomes darker due to the formation of acids and the resins, and resulting in there is a formation of the sludge. So different specifications for the classifications of the transformer oil, which we can understand in IS-1866 and IEC-296. Then we have second one, that is synthetic hydrocarbons. So these are used generally in the power cables. Polyolefins are the dielectric of the choice for the applications in the case of power cables. Over 55% of the synthetic hydrocarbons in all over the world which are produced is of polyolefins. So this is exhibit the property as same as the mineral oil. Okay, means synthetic hydrocarbons, and this will exhibit the property same as the mineral oil. Then we have a chlorinated hydrocarbons. So these are the composition of benzene and diphyl are chlorinated to produce a chlorinated aromatic compound called ascaryls. or simply we can call it as a PCB. These are high fire point and excellent electrical properties, but they have banned because of the serious health hazards nowadays. Then we have next one is silicon wires. It is the alternative for the PCB, but these are very expensive. Even at a temperature of 150 degrees Celsius, they exhibit high long-term thermal stability. And also because these are very costly in nature, so it is not affordable to go for a silicon wires. Then we have esters. There are the two types of synthetic esters are used. One is organic esters and another one is phosphate esters. Organic esters have high boiling point in relation to their viscosity, and therefore have high fire points. They have good viscosity temperature relationship, extensively used in the capacitors. Whereas in case of phosphate esters, have high boiling point and low inflammability, and therefore they are used in the transformers. Are to be installed in the hazardous areas of the installed area. Okay, so these are the things in coming to the latest heat esters in the case of organic and phosphate esters. Nowadays we have latest development. Some of the oils have been introduced in the recent. They are marketing in different commercial names. At high temperature hydrocarbon oils. Okay, so nowadays we have STH. These are oil having the good electrical insulating and adequate heat transfer properties. And also these are chemical similar to that mineral oils. Okay, so this is nothing but it is same as a transformer oil, but possess high boiling point and high fire point. So these are the classification. Coming to the characteristics of liquid dielectrics, they should possess good dielectric properties, excellent heat transfer characteristics, and must be chemically stable under a range of a condition under which the equipment operates. Let's we can have briefly discussion on these things like electrical properties, then heat transfer characteristics and the chemical stability. First we can discuss that electrical properties. These are the essential in determining the dielectric performance of the liquid dielectrics or capacitance per unit value, or we can call it as its relative permittivity, then its resistivity, then we have loss tangent, or generally we can call it as power factor, which is an indication of the power loss under AC applications, then its ability to withstand high dielectric stress. Then coming to the permittivities, the most of the petroleum oil vary from 2 to 2.6, while those of the silicon oil which is varies from 2 to 73. In the case of non-polar liquids, the permittivity is directly proportional to the frequency. In the polar, it is independent on the frequency of polar, but in the case of polar liquids such as water, it changes with respect to the frequency. Let's we can have an example. The permittivity of the water is 78 at 50 hertz and reduced to about 5 at 1 megahertz. So this is nothing but polarization is directly proportional to the frequency. Then for the resistivity of the liquid dielectric media, it should be more than 10 to the power of 16 ohm meter. And most of the liquids, pure state, which exhibit this property. Then coming to the power factor of the dielectric under AC will determine its performance under load conditions. The power factor is measured of a power loss, as it is a more important parameter in the case of a cable and the capacitor. However, in the case of transformers, we will neglect, because the dielectric loss in the transformer is negligible compared to that copper and the iron losses. Let's see to that pure and dry transformer oil will have a very low power factor varying around 10 to the power of minus 4 at 20 degrees Celsius and 10 to the power of minus 3 at 90 degrees Celsius at a frequency of 50 Hz. So there is a small change in the values. However, it is more important in the case of the cables and the capacitors. The dielectric strength is most important parameter in the choice of the liquid dielectric for the specific application. So it is mainly depending upon atomic and molecular property of the liquid. However, under particle condition, it is mainly depending upon the material of the electrode, temperature, and the type of the voltage which is applied, and the gas content in the liquid. The dielectric strength, by changing the molecular property of the liquid, the above factor which will control the breakdown strength and will lead to that electrical breakdown of the dielectric, liquid dielectric. So this is subject to that electrical properties. Then next we have heat transfer characteristics. In equipments filled with a liquid dielectric like a transformer, cable, circuit breakers, heat is transferred mainly by natural convection. Under natural atmospheric condition, cooling convection is given by N is equal to F into K to the power of 3 AC by V to the power of N, where K is nothing but thermal conductivity, A is the coefficient of expansion, C is specific heat per unit volume, V is kinetic viscosity, and when N varies from 0.25 to 0.33, the main factor that control the heat transfers are thermal conductivity and the viscosity. We have to be more wise enough to choose the between conductivity and the viscosity. So from this equation, it can be seen that higher value of the K is preferable for the operators like operating continuously at high temperature. In the other hand, a low value of the K and high viscosity can lead to that there is a localized overheating or even electrical burnout may take place. So they should be wise enough to choose between conductivity and the viscosity. However, silicon oils do not exhibit these properties and can pose severe overheating problems in the electrical equipment for the liquid dielectric medium. Then coming to that, the chemical stability. In-service insulating liquid are subjected to thermal and electrical stress in the presence of material like O2, water, fibrous, and decomposition product of the solid insulation. These are singly or combinations. It will cause to that there is a degradation of the liquid, resulting solid, soluble, and gaseous products we can form, which is the result in corrosion, impairment of heat transfer, deterioration of the electrical properties. This will increase in dielectric losses. So sometimes there is a formation of the discharges and arcing between the two electrodes. If any remedials is not action is not been taken, and this cycle is going to be continued, and even worsening of the liquid purity and the equipment condition, these are the two things which is going to add up of the chemical instability. So resulting in there is a breakdown takes place between the two electrodes. Next concept is pure liquids and commercial liquids. Pure liquids are those which are chemically pure and do not contain any other impurities. Even the traces of 1 into 10 to the power of 19 These are structurally simple, like example of pure liquids. Some of the pure liquids are N-hexane, N-heptane, and other paraffin hydrocarbons. In the other hand, the commercial liquids, oils, which are not chemically pure, normally consist of mixtures of complex organic molecules, which are not chemically pure. It is a consist of mixtures of complex organic molecules, okay, which cannot be easily specified or reproduced in a series of the experiments. So we have to do some purification. We are using distillation and sulfuric acid likewise. So the main impurities in liquid dielectrics are dust, moisture content, dissolved gases, and ionic impurities. So we are using the different methods for the purification, like filtration, centrifuging, then degassing and distillation, chemical treatment. These are some of the examples. So so water is removed by using the drying the agents. Okay, drying the agents. So this is a distillation process, drying the agents, and sometimes with the sulfuric acid to remove wax and residues, and are washed with the caustic soda and distilled water. The system is commonly used the closed cycle liquid process for the purification to prepare a liquid as per the requirement. This provides for the cycling of the liquid. The liquid flows from the reservoir through a distillation column where ionic impurities are removed. Then water is removed by drying out or frozen out in the low temperature. Then the gases dissolve in the liquid are removed by cooling the tower and pumped out to that by vacuum pumps. Then this will flow to that filter where the dust particles are removed. Okay, and the liquid thus purified is then to flow back to the test cell. The vacuum system will helps us to remove moisture and the other gaseous impurities. So this is one of the example for the purification. Okay, then we have a breakdown test. So we are using the different methods for the to conduct the breakdown test. We are expecting around 50 to 100 kV. It is our requirement is of 5 MV/cm. But we may get around 50 to 100 kV. The electrodes are used for the breakdown generally is of 0.5 to 1 cm diameter and are spacing at 100 to 200 micrometer. So sometimes we are using a parallel plane uniform field to conduct this breakdown test. So electrode separation is very important phenomenon because we are using very low amount of the liquid for the conduction of the breakdown test. So generally we may get around 50 to 100 kV/cm. This is the breakdown test where we can conduct. Then coming to the how actually the conduction breakdown takes place in the pure liquid. So when low electric field applying of 1 kV/cm are applied, the conductivities will be around 10⁻¹⁸ to 10⁻²⁰ mO/cm are obtained. So what we are telling is it is a pure in nature, but we should not, but we cannot make sure that there is some element which is present after doing the filtration as well. Probably due to that, the impurities which are remaining after doing the purifications, when the voltage is applied, current not only increases rapidly but also undergoes a violent fluctuation which will die out after some time. So from this figure which we can understand that at the initial moments there is no field added, when because of the high voltage electric field there is the process of violent fluctuation, and then there is a gradual increase in the value of ionization. At this point there is a possibility of the conduction lead to that there is a breakdown between the two electrodes. So once again if we redraw this, the figure, From the starting point with very small current, we have a three distinct regions, ionic, saturation, and the field added. So at very low fields, the current is due to that deionization, dissociation of the ions. Then the intermediate region, this is a saturation value. At a high field, the current generated because of the field added electron emission from the cathodes get multiplied. So this is what exactly is explained by Townsend mechanism. So the exact mechanism, the conduction, the breakdown, till now it is not known because of the gas molecules which is a presence between, which was liberated in the two dielectrics because of the dissociation of the element or chemical deterioration. So this is simple manner we can say that Townsend primary and the secondary ionization and the breakdown field is approached and the current increases rapidly due to that similar how exactly we know in the case of ionization process for Townsend first ionization and the secondary ionization. The breakdown voltage mainly depends on the field, gap separation, work function of the material and the temperature of the cathode. In addition to this, some of the things which we are adding up, that is liquid viscosity, temperature, density and the molecular structure of the liquid also influences the breakdown strength of the liquid. However, some of the things which are making that, it has been observed that increase in the breakdown strength is is more if the dissolved gases are electronegative nature. This is what from partial pressure of the oxygen aboard. And similarly, in the case of liquid hydrostatic pressure increases the breakdown strength. Okay, this is the two things which is explained here. So this is nothing but conduction and the breakdown phenomenon in the case of the pure liquids.